ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಶರಣು ಶರಣಾರ್ಥಿ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಆತ್ಮಸ್ಥೈರ್ಯ ಈ ಒಂದು ಅರ್ಥಪೂರ್ಣ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಕ್ಕೆ ತಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಆದರದ ಸ್ವಾಗತ ಸುಸ್ವಾಗತ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ ಶರಣ ಬಂಧುಗಳೇ ನಮ್ಮ ದೇಹವೇ ದೇಗುಲ ಅಂತ ಬಸವಣ್ಣನವರು ಹೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ದೇಹವನ್ನು ದೇಗುಲ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ ನಾವು ದೇವರನ್ನು ಹುಡುಕಕ್ಕೆ ಬೇರೆ ಎಲ್ಲೂ ಹೋಗಬೇಕಾದಿಲ್ಲ ಆತ್ಮವಿಶ್ವಾಸ ಹೊಂದಿದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಏನೆಲ್ಲ ಸಾಧಿಸಬಹುದು ಅನ್ನೋದು ತಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಗೊತ್ತೇ ಇದೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಈ ಒಂದು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಏನಿದೆ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಆತ್ಮಸ್ಥೈರ್ಯ ವಿಶೇಷವಾಗಿ ದ್ವಿತೀಯ ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಪರೀಕ್ಷೆ ಬರೆಯಲಿರುವಂಥ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ವಿಷಯಾಧಾರಿತ ಮಾಹಿತಿಗಳನ್ನು ಕೊಡುವುದರ ಮೂಲಕ ಅವರಲ್ಲಿ ಆತ್ಮಸ್ಥೈರ್ಯವನ್ನು ತುಂಬುವಂಥ ಪ್ರಯತ್ನವನ್ನು ನಾವು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ ಈ ದಿನ ನಮ್ಮೊಂದಿಗೆ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಆತ್ಮಸ್ಥೈರ್ಯ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮದಲ್ಲಿ ವಿಶೇಷವಾಗಿ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಭಾಷೆ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಭಾಷಾ ಪತ್ರಿಕೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷನ್ನು ಯಾವ್ಯಾವ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳು ಬರೀತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅವರೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ನಾವು ಸಲಹೆ ಸೂಚನೆಗಳನ್ನು ನೀಡಲಿದ್ದೇವೆ ಈ ವಿಚಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ನಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆ ಮಾತನಾಡಲು ಚರ್ಚೆ ಮಾಡಲು ಸಂವಾದ ಮಾಡಲು ಶ್ರೀಮತಿ ಸುಚಿತ್ರಾ ಜೂಡ್ ಅವರು ನಮ್ಮ ಜೊತೆ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ ಬನ್ನಿ ಅವರನ್ನು ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಕ್ಕೆ ಆತ್ಮೀಯವಾಗಿ ಬರಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಳೋಣ ಸುಚಿತ್ರಾ ಅವರೇ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ ಹಾಗೆ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮಕ್ಕೆ ಆತ್ಮೀಯವಾದಂತಹ ಸ್ವಾಗತ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ ಶ್ರೀಮತಿ ಸುಚಿತ್ರಾ ಜೂಡ್ ಅವರು ಮೂಲತಃ ಮಧ್ಯಪ್ರದೇಶದವರು ಅವರು ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಲಿಟ್ರೇಚರ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಎಮ್ ಎ ಬಿ ಎಡ್ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ದೇವಿ ಅಹಲ್ಯ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಇಂದೋರ್ ಮಧ್ಯಪ್ರದೇಶದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರು ಮುಗಿಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಪ್ರಸ್ತುತ ಗುಡ್ವಿಲ್ ಪಿ ಯು ಕಾಲೇಜಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ವಿಭಾಗದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಲೆಕ್ಚರರ್ ಆಗಿ ಕೆಲಸವನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತರೆ ತಮ್ಮೆಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಗೊತ್ತೇ ಇರೋ ಹಾಗೆ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಅನ್ನುವಂಥದ್ದು ಒಂದು ಭಾಷೆ ಆಂಗ್ಲರು ಬ್ರಿಟಿಷರು ನಮಗೆ ಈ ಭಾಷೆಯನ್ನು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೋದರು ನಮ್ಮ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದ ಅಥವಾ ನಮ್ಮ ಭಾರತ ದೇಶದ ಎಲ್ಲ ಆಡಳಿತವು ಬಹುತೇಕ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಭಾಷೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನಡೆಯುತ್ತೆ ತಮಗೂ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋ ಹಾಗೆ ಸೊ ಹಾಗಾಗಿ ದ್ವಿತೀಯ ಪಿ ಯು ಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷನ್ನು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಗ್ವೇಜ್ ಆಗಿ ಇಡಲಾಗಿದೆ ಈ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಭಾಷೆ ಈಗಲೂ ಸಹ ಬಹಳ ಕಷ್ಟ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳುವವರು ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಬೀದರ್ ಗುಲ್ಬರ್ಗ ಈ ಥರದಂತಹ ಬಹಳ ದೂರದ ಊರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ಸೌಲಭ್ಯಗಳು ಇರೋಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಭಾಷೆ ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನು ಬಹಳ ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳು ಕಷ್ಟಪಟ್ಟು ಓದಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ ಆದರೆ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಅನ್ನೋಂಥದ್ದು ಅಷ್ಟು ಕಷ್ಟ ಏನಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಸುಲಭವಾದಂತಹ ಭಾಷೆನೇ ಸೊ ಈ ದಿನದ ನಮ್ಮ ಈ ಒಂದು ಸಂವಾದದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಭಾಷೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಕನಿಷ್ಠ ಪಕ್ಷ 35 ಅಂಕಗಳನ್ನು ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ತಗೋಬಹುದು ಅಥವಾ 50 ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಅಥವಾ 90 ಅಥವಾ 100ಕ್ಕೆ 100 ಅಂಕಗಳನ್ನು ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಪಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಬಹುದು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನೆಲ್ಲ ಸಲಹೆ ಸೂಚನೆಗಳು ನಿಮಗೆ ಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಇದೆಲ್ಲದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಈಗಾಗಲೇ ಚರ್ಚೆ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಬಂದಿದ್ದೀವಿ ಬನ್ನಿ ಸುಚಿತ್ರಾ ಜೂಡ್ ಅವ್ರ ಜೊತೆ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಭಾಷೆಯನ್ನು ಅತ್ಯಂತ ಸರಳ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಮಾಡಬಹುದು ಅನ್ನೋದನ್ನು ನಿಮಗೆ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಭಾಷೆ ಆಗಿರೋದ್ರಿಂದ ಸುಚಿತ್ರಾ ಜೂಡ್ ಅವರು ತಮ್ಮ ಸಂವಾದವನ್ನು ಸಂಪೂರ್ಣವಾಗಿ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ನೆರವೇರಿಸ್ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅದು ಬಹುಶಃ ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ನಾನಾದರೂ ಭಾವಿಸಿದ್ದೇನೆ ಸುಚಿತ್ರಾ ಸೊ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ವುಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಟು ನೋ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ವೆರಿ ಡಿಫಿಕಲ್ಟ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್
ಆಬ್ಸೊಲ್ಯೂಟ್ಲಿ ನಾಟ್ ದೇ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಥಿಂಕ್ ದೇ ಗೆಟ್ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಕೇರ್ಡ್ ವೆನ್ ದೇ ಹಿಯರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಬಟ್ ಇಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಹೌ ಯು ಟೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಹೌ ಮಚ್ ಟೈಮ್ ಯು ಸ್ಪೆಂಡ್ ಆನ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ವೆಶನ್ಸ್ ದ ವೇ ಯು ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್
So you mean to say English is very easy?
It is easy.
And it is a just a language?
It is just a language, how you speak Kannada, how you speak Hindi, how you speak the other languages.
Okay. So Chitra, I just want to know, past 12 years you are teaching English. So syllabus changes, question paper pattern changes. So let us just see for the coming 2019 exam, what is the question paper pattern for 100 marks? What is section A, what is section B? Can you just briefly tell us?
Yeah. For this particular exams pattern, we have first set of questions are for 12 marks.
Okay.
That is 1 mark question.
Mm.
That goes, the heading goes as answer in a word or a phrase or a sentence.
Mm-hmm.
So you are expected maximum to write one sentence. If you even write one word, it is sufficient.
Mm-hmm.
Now the first thing is there are around 4 questions that comes from poetry,
mm-hmm.
which is very important.
Mm.
And we have 6 poems in our syllabus this time.
Mm.
So if you just concentrate on the 6 poetries, out of that 4 questions you get from poetry. So it is very easy to get 1 mark each for, so easily you can score 4 marks out of the 12 questions. And rest of the questions are from the literature, from the prose part.
Mm.
The second set of questions are 4 mark questions. That you can write in 80 to 100 words. In that you have 3 questions which are from the poetry again.
Mm-hmm.
So here again and again I'm repeating about poetry because you can easily score marks from the poetry when you study only the little part and you can score more marks.
Mm-hmm.
So 3 questions from the poetry, even if you attempt 2, you are almost getting 3 to 6 marks out of those 4 mark questions, and rest is again from the literature part. Then you have 3 questions of 6 marks, out of which again 1 question is out of poetry. So if you prepare your poetry section very nicely, you can easily score 22 marks in your first set of questions itself. Then we go about the other set of questions that are from the unseen passage. They give you a passage which you have not read before. So the first thing you have to do is you have to read the passage very, very carefully. Take your time, read each in line very carefully, because all the 10 questions below that are based on entirely that passage. So if you read the passage carefully, you will be able to answer all the questions very easily. So keep your focus, keep your attention. In that, the last 2 questions will be a synonym. Synonym means a similar kind of words. So for that, you should prepare a little bit in advance to read your textbook. They mostly ask from the textbooks. So if you read your textbooks and search through the dictionaries, you will easily find out the meanings of those words.
So actually, can you just explain one by one? See, as you told me, 12 questions for the part. Then after that,
it is 4 mark questions, out of which there are 3 questions from the poetry.
Just take an example, and then how much quantity should be written?
Basically, if you write in the 4 mark questions, 4 points, 4 value points if you cover, you have already scored 2 marks out of 4 marks. And then rest, the other 2 marks goes on your language. So here already you have scored 2 marks if you just give the value points and stick on to your reference. Whatever context is there, stick on to. Don't write the entire story in the answer. Just stick on. If you stick on to the value points, in every answer there will be value points. What is asked exactly, the name of the person, the reference from which lesson it is asked. If you focus on that, you have already scored 2 marks out of 4 marks. Same thing goes for 6 marks. In 6 marks question, you are expected to write little more. That is around 200 words. So the explanation part is more in 6 marks questions. And that is also have in your blueprints in your textbooks. You will know from which lesson how many marks questions are asked. If you just go through your blueprint in your textbook, it's there behind, you will know which lesson carries how much marks. So that will help you to focus on which lesson more and to give little less attention to the other lessons. So this was mainly about the literature part.
Okay.
The next set of questions we have from the grammar, which is a very scoring side. Students generally get scared with grammar. But if you little bit prepare yourself in advance, you will be easily able to answer those questions. Now here, the main problem is they have a question based on passive voice. They don't understand and they don't directly ask the question, change it into passive voice. They ask the question, write the right form of the verb.
Okay.
So here is where children get confused. What they do, say for example, if they have asked you to write the right form of the verb build, they just write built and leave it. Was built is important here.
Okay.
That is what they fail to, because they are asking you for second year PUC. This is for first years, they have learnt only the past tense. But here they have added on to write the passive form of the verb, where they need to add the helping verb, that is was, were, is, along with your verb, past tense of the word. So that is where children lose marks. They just write the past tense and they leave it. That is very important, because it's a very scoring place. You easily score 4 marks over there. Just by writing 2 words everywhere, you are scoring 4 marks. So very closely, students should pay attention on that passive verb form of verb.
Okay. After that,
then they have something called as completion of the dialogue.
Okay.
That is also a very scoring place. That comes for 4 marks. And they give you hints. They give you, like, for example, I am Ravi. Now you have to complete the dialogue. So you are supposed to say, hello Ravi, how are you?
Okay.
Then they will give you a context. Say suppose they are meeting at the bus stop for the first time. How will you talk to a person for the first time when you meet? Okay, it is nice meeting you. Could you tell me the address to reach this particular place? They will give you a context in which you will have to complete that dialogue.
Okay.
Say suppose examples they give, if you go to a librarian for the first time, what are the questions you will ask? So what first thing you'll start with, hello ma'am, good morning. Half of the thing is over there. Then could you help me to find out a grammar textbook? Okay, that is how you approach, that is how you ask a person.
Mm-hmm.
So you will be given hints over there. Mm-hmm. Half of the sentence will be completed. You have to just complete it.
Mm-hmm.
So this is again a very scoring place.
Mm-hmm.
If you read it carefully, you have again scored 4 marks here.
Okay.
So these are places where a child, if he just focuses on these things, he's almost able to score 35 marks.
Okay.
Up till here.
Huh.
But still question paper is not over.
Okay.
There is so many things. So this is basically for children who feel English is very tough.
Hmm.
If they focus on these things itself, they will be able to score 35 marks.
So you were explaining me the pattern, grammar,
yes,
part and all. So why don't you go to the other next part,
yes,
and then explain,
yes,
us?
The, yeah, other part, very important part, is note,
yeah,
making exercise.
Hmm.
Here again they give you a passage,
hmm,
and they give you a table underneath. Okay, now again here you should read the passage very carefully. And there are just table down where they will be asking you which year this was done.
Hmm.
So the years will be mentioned there. Okay, what are the things this company produces? Say suppose strawberries, apple and oranges.
Hmm.
So all that will be there in the passage. You have to just write it in the table.
Hmm.
And very important is to draw the table.
Hmm.
Some children just write the answer. So, and they randomly write it up and down.
Hmm.
That order has to be maintained. Because,
okay,
that shows that how carefully you are reading the passage,
hmm,
how much you have understood the passage, and how well you are able to answer it.
Okay. See, sometimes it so happens, we lecturers like few chapters. It is very, I love to teach.
Hmm.
Such things happens in our mind. But sometimes students feel, oh, it's very difficult to understand, mm, like that. Do you have any particular lesson you felt like, oh, it's very nice to teach and it's very easy to make the children to understand? Do you have any poems or anything in second year?
Usually children really like Romeo and Juliet.
Okay.
Because they are already in a certain age, they are very fascinated or attracted,
oh,
to,
okay,
this. And that's the first poem.
Okay.
So before they come to college itself,
they
read
this.
It. They know the story. So they are very excited about that particular poem.
Okay. If you can remember any questions that last year or before last year, something which has come from the Romeo for 1 mark or 2 mark, whatever, the can you just explain, take a question and then answer to that.
Okay. The question was asked previous year, who loves most, whose love is more, Juliet's or Romeo's?
Hmm. What? So, how much was the marks?
It carried 1 marks.
Okay,
but
1 mark.
That is an analysis of the entire poem.
Hmm.
The answer is not straight there that Juliet loved Romeo more or Romeo loved Juliet.
Hmm.
But when you read the poem, you will know whose love was more for each other. So the answer was Romeo loved Juliet more.
Okay.
So like that, you will generally get questions based on that. How, what was more attractive in Juliet, which Romeo liked? That is the most question that is asked. They will ask you in different way. What was fascinating in Juliet? What was more that attractive, which he forgot the whole world and he was behind Juliet? That was the question. They turn up, they change the language and they ask,
huh,
generally.
So Suchitra, as we all know, this English paper, first language English, it is not just the Bengalurians are writing,
yes,
it's for all over Karnataka,
yes,
the PUC board is conducting the exam. See, people who live in Bengaluru have learned from the English medium, for them English would be very easy. But whereas you think about the rural area, people, maybe the parents are not educated, maybe the poverty and other problems are there, still they need to write English.
Yes.
So what we are focusing, so a child should not fail in English.
Mm.
As you said, it's an English, it's a very easy subject. So just give us some few tips. A child, even from very, what do you say, a below average child also should take minimum 35 and he or she has to pass. Do you have any tips for them?
That's what, as I told in the beginning,
mm,
if out of all the 14-15 lessons, they,
mm,
focus on the 6 poetries,
mm,
which covers the 4 questions in the first main,
mm,
3 questions in the second main and 1 question in the 6 marks. So they have already covered around 22 marks here.
Mm-hmm.
If one question they write it correctly, they,
mm-hmm,
have already scored 4 marks and 4 marks in the next section,
mm-hmm,
and the other 6 marks. You may not get 6 out of 6. You may give 5 for your excellent answer.
Mm-hmm.
So almost the child has covered 14-15 marks in the first 3 set of questions.
Mm-hmm.
Just by following few tips, not necessarily you have to answer an excellent language, but just focusing on the poetry part, you have covered so much of the sections.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, as I told you, that passive voice that carries 4 marks.
Mm.
Then completion of the dialogue. Mm. If they focus on, it is very simple.
Mm.
They give very simple conversation. Just meeting a person for the first time or meeting somebody at the bus stop,
mm.
going to the library. Very mm. simple conversation.
I know.
So the children
which we day to day, every day we use,
yes.
we talk.
No? We generally talk in our colloquial language, mm. in our mother tongues. But here, if you little concentrate, little if you think and try to related to English, you will be able to answer those questions. Completion of the dialogues, which is very easy. Every
okay.
day we do that.
Okay. So our next focus is below average. We have already spoken in that. So a student want to take 60 to 70 like that. Any
yes.
tips for them?
They have to again focus on the 1 mark questions
mm.
because 1 mark question, 12 marks questions are there for 1 mark,
mm.
and the very good part of it is you have to answer in a word or a phrase or maximum a sentence.
Mm.
So just by writing one word in each answer, you are scoring 12 marks.
See, sometimes
so
I interrupt you. See, sometimes some students say, I wrote only one word. The teacher didn't give me the full mark. She was expecting me to write one complete meaningful sentence. Is it necessary?
Not in the first part.
Okay.
They are very precise when they ask the question.
Mm.
Answer in a word
mm.
or a phrase or mm. a sentence.
Mm-hmm.
So it is understood that maximum is one sentence.
Mm.
So they will generally ask you a question which requires only a word or a phrase.
Okay.
Who loved Romeo more? It is Juliet. Or you write Juliet, you are getting 1 mark. Even if you write a story,
mm.
you will not get 2 marks.
Mm.
It is 1 mark, you will get only 1 mark.
Okay.
So if they focus on that 1 mark question, for that they have to read the lessons very carefully.
Mm.
Because generally they ask from anywhere from the lesson.
Okay.
So for that, if they read the lessons carefully 2 to 3 times,
mm.
they will be able to answer those questions.
Huh. So, do you have a essay or letter writing?
They have a letter writing. That is again a scoring place.
Okay.
Generally, students think that if they write the format, it is enough.
Hmm.
There is, of course, marks for format. Beginning, that is the from part, to whom you're writing the address, who's writing the letter,
hmm.
then to whom are you writing,
hmm.
then the subject, and to whom you're addressing. Okay. And then the way you end the letter, that is thanking you, yours sincerely, and the name of the person. And for the second PUC, they have a resume. They generally give you to write an application.
Okay.
It is like you are writing an application for applying a job.
Mm.
So they will give you the details.
Mm.
They suppose you are applying for the post of a lecturer.
Mm.
So in that, you have to mention that I have finished this particular degree, your qualification, and you have to tell I have worked here, experience. They will give you all the details.
Mm-hmm.
They will give you the details there, which you have to use it in the sentence format.
Okay.
So format carries marks, 2 marks out of 5 marks. If you write the format correctly, you have already scored 2 marks.
Mm-hmm.
But body of the letter also is equally important.
Okay.
That you should divide it into 3 parts.
Mm-hmm.
First, you salute the person. Hello, ma'am. This is so and so. I am addressing, talking. That is the first part of the letter writing.
Okay.
Secondly, what you want to ask. You are asking for a job. You should tell your capabilities. I am capable of doing this. I have experience in doing this. That is what you write in the second part.
Mm.
Thirdly, you consider them or you tell them that I am efficient person. I'll be able to meet up your needs. I'll be able to do how to your according to your needs. So that is the third part, how you conclude the letter. So writing the letter in the 3 parts is very important. First the format part, then writing the body of the letter and concluding.
Okay.
And I'm sure they would have taught in your colleges how to write it, that you stick on to only to the left side.
Okay.
You don't write anything on the right hand side.
Okay.
That is how the latest formatted
format
is.
So do we have essay?
They don't have essays.
Essays.
That is converted into speech writing.
Okay.
They give you a particular topic, say suppose you are the president of the college
mm.
and it is an occasion of farewell day.
Mm.
So how will you address the gathering?
Okay.
So you should consider yourself as the president of the college. Okay. First thing is you address the crowd.
Mm.
That is salutation. Good afternoon, good evening, or whichever time the program is
mm.
based on that. And then honor the guests who are present there. That is how you start it. You don't just abruptly or straight away just start with your message. You first wish the people, make people comfortable who are listening to you. Okay. Then later you go into the speech writing.
Okay.
And that your language, focus on your language little, the way they use the word, little formal words should be used in the letter, in the
okay.
speech writing.
So sometimes it so happens, but I was expecting 100 out of 100, but whereas I got only 97, I got only 98. They're not happy, they're very ambitious nowadays. They want 100 out of 100. So what could be the reason? I don't know what exactly went wrong and all, but whereas nowadays it is a trend that not in maths and physics, even in the language, they want to take 100 out of 100. So can you just give us few tips to get 100 out of 100 in English?
Generally, languages, you don't get 100 out of 100. It is you have to have an excellent language. That is flawless.
Okay.
Every dots, every commas are counted.
Yes.
So even when we evaluate the papers, we are not supposed to give full marks in the answer. Grammar, of course, you score full marks. That's why I have been telling you, focus on your grammar, focus on your completion of dialogues. This is places where you get complete marks. But where comes of question answers writing, we are not supposed, even excellent answers, out of four, I will only give 3.5 marks.
So you feel still it is not the best?
It is not bad, because even the evaluators have to prove that it is flawless. There is not even a dot mistake. So it generally doesn't happen. There will be a comma mistake. If you say 4 out of 4, that means there should not be a comma, a dot, a semicolon, any mistake is not there. So generally that is not possible. A child tends to write a language nicely, but he forgets to put the annotations, he forgets to put the punctuation. So that is where they lose marks.
So I think I have heard you going to evaluation paper, evaluation for so many years.
Almost 8 to 10
years.
8 to 10 years.
So what have you seen? What is your experience over there? Like when you are really valuing the paper, sometimes do you feel like giving one more mark extra to pass that child? Because is that all happening?
It happens. It happens. It depends on the which particular place we get the papers from. You will know about the set of questions, the way they answer it, the language usage. By that you will know from which particular place that some children, the answer pattern, it will be excellent the way they write. It is written very well, especially the answer section. I mean, they fail to complete in the grammar section. That means it shows that they have mugged up the answers. They write it so well. But when it comes to logical thinking about grammar, which is a science, which is an application part of English, like how we have practicals in physics, chemistry and all. So grammar is nothing else but application. That is like a lab. You're using what you have learned in an application level. So that is where they make mistakes. Some children, by fluke, they write off the right answers. It is like because of ticking and certain things. They score marks like that.
Okay.
One more thing the children fail to understand is they forget to attempt all the questions.
Okay.
That is very important.
Okay.
And thing is, we choose the best answers. Sometimes you know one answer to an extent, you know the other answer also. So we are asked to choose the best answer. Even if the child has written the extra answer, we choose the best out of that. That is what we are asked to do when you evaluate. So it is fine if you have sufficient time, if you know both the answers. If one answer you are okay, you're not so confident about it, but the other answer you're very good. So you must be in a dilemma to decide whether to write this or write that. But if you know both, if you attempt, if you have time, I'm not telling you write extra answers, but if in order to score more marks, we are supposed to give marks for the better answer. So that is where it counts on us. So definitely you will score marks. And don't leave any questions. Sometimes there are some mistakes in the question paper, and children think that, oh, this is wrong, let us not attempt it. They lose marks again there. If there is a mistake in the question paper, we will be forced to give 1 mark or 2 marks, how much ever the question carries marks. So don't leave any questions. That is one thing that the children students should know.
See, one more biggest issue. When you really speak to the students and talk to them and all, they speak manageable English and all. When it comes to writing, many students will fail. So what is your tip that they have to improve their writing? See, because after all, in the year end, they need to write the exam. Oral exam is not there, it's only the writing exam. How to improve their writing?
First thing, if you have to write good, is you have to read good. They have to read lot of books. I insist my students generally to read newspapers. Listening part you learn from listening to news generally, not listening all the scrap. You don't learn anything. But news, you have all kind of things that you can learn from. Information based, plus the way the language is delivered. You learn from there. But to write good, you have to read good. They have to really good read good literature. Some good books, some good authors,
novels,
motivational speech, novels, whichever their interest is in. But not basically comics or anything that they don't give you a good language part. You should read good motivational books, okay, where you will know how to write. In fact, reading newspapers also help them to enhance their vocabulary. They learn new words. I always tell my students, sit with a dictionary when you're reading the newspaper. In a day, if even if you learn 10 words a day, you in a month you have learned 300 words. And then make a use when you're writing, when you're talking.
Okay.
Just filling your head is not enough. That implication part is very, very important.
Okay.
So that really helps them to, but see, I always tell them, a language is a simple, it is bland, but how you make it beautiful?
Okay.
By adding accessories, you know, you add idioms, phrases, and in every languages they have, you know, to beautify the language.
Yes, yes, yes.
Like how you say some idioms like, who will bell the cat?
Yes.
Who will break the ice? Okay. This person has a green finger. Generally, they say people who are good in gardening, they say this person has a green finger. So it makes people to think, oh, what is this person writing, you know? It attracts their attention. Your communication language is basically communication. How well you attract person's attention, that is the talking part. Writing again, the same things, if you use and beautify your language, it'll draw the reader's attention.
Okay, so in spite of all the things, so do you have any other tips for the children?
One more thing I have noticed is generally the children from science streams, they don't concentrate on the language.
Yes, yes.
They are more focused on the physics, maths, chemistry, maths and all that. They feel language is okay, manageable, we will do it. But they don't realize that these are the places which helps them to enhance their percentage.
Yes.
If you are scoring 90% in language and you are scoring somewhere variably 70 to 80% in other thing, your percentage has already come between 80%. So they fail to realize that language is very, very important.
Okay.
And one more thing is, now it's high time for them, but what they try to do is just one day before they start studying. Languages generally doesn't come like that. You have to spend time every day, especially on the grammar part. 10 to 15 minutes if they spend every day on the grammar part, it is more than enough.
Okay. See, so far we spoke about the question paper pattern and other things. Whereas, after all, this is all related to subject only. I just want you to focus on something out of the subject. See, nowadays the students are always into mobile, Facebook, internet and so many other things. They are always into, you know, some PUBG, all these games, especially boys and all. So you just tell me how we can bring them to studies and all, any other tips that mentally we have to support them. I don't say internet is bad and all, but whereas too much during that too, the coming first is the March final exams are there. So now from we have hardly few days, 15 days is also not there. So just tell us something that in these 15 days, what best they can do.
The first thing is that I will just give you a few points. If you are sitting with a pen and thing, you can really write it. It will really help you. First thing is overcoming procrastination. That is, keep on postponing things. Oh, I'll do it tomorrow. I will start it. That is the first step where you have failed. First thing is decide in your mind, I will sit down to study. How much ever your parents tell, how much ever your teachers tell, until you decide in your mind, you cannot do it. Nobody can be keeping an eye on you like on like a CCTV camera, 24/7. Okay, you have to have your own mindset. Decide, I have to study. I will do it. First build your own confidence. That is where you have won the half victory. Right? Then second is giving excuses. No, this because of this I could not do that. Come out of that. You are not playing a blame game or blaming others. Ultimately you are the loser. You keep blaming 100 things. You it's not the other person who is losing. You are the one who are losing it.
Okay.
So your main thing is your attention and focus. Especially for this youngsters at this time, they lack that focus and attention. They cannot concentrate more than 15 minutes. They get distracted very soon. So you have to bring your mind under control, and only you can do it.
Okay.
Only the student can do it. If I stand with a stick also next to the child, if he doesn't want, or he or she doesn't want to study, it will not go.
Definitely.
So it is basically in their own hands that they try to focus on their own things. Then that's what creating a successful mindset. Once you create a successful mindset, you have already won the victory. You won it in your mind, you will win it definitely. So the people say nowadays, so many people talk about positive thinking. So positive thinking involves positive actions. Just having positive thinking will not help you. There are positive actions that you do. And secondly is, children try to do shortcuts. There is no shortcut for hard work. For success and for hard work. Hard work will definitely pay you one day. The more you work hard, you will see the results.
Okay.
Nowadays, a saying, people say, work smart, not hard.
Uh-huh.
But to work smart, they have to first work hard.
Yes, exactly.
There is time when you have to work hard. Then yes. only you will be able to work smart.
ಇದುವರೆಗೂ ಸುಚಿತ್ರಾ ಜೂಡವರು ಮಧ್ಯಪ್ರದೇಶದಿಂದ ಬಂದಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಇಲ್ಲೇ ಬೆಂಗಳೂರಿನಲ್ಲಿ ವಾಸ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವರು ನಮಗೆ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ ಭಾಷೆ, ಪ್ರಥಮ ಭಾಷೆ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷು ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಬರೀಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನುವಂತಹ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸರಳವಾದಂಥ ಮಾರ್ಗಗಳನ್ನು ನಮಗೆ ತಿಳಿಸ್ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅವರಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಆಭಾರಿಗಳಾಗಿದ್ದೇವೆ. ಬಸವ ವಾಹಿನಿಯ ಪರವಾಗಿ ಅವರಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಹೃತ್ಪೂರ್ವಕವಾದಂತಹ ಧನ್ಯವಾದಗಳನ್ನು ಅರ್ಪಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಥ್ಯಾಂಕ್ ಯು ಸೋ ಮಚ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್. ನಮ್ಮ ಈ ಕಾರ್ಯಕ್ರಮ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿಯಾಗಿತ್ತು ಅನ್ನುವಂತಹ ಎಲ್ಲ ಸಲಹೆ ಸೂಚನೆಗಳನ್ನು ದಯಮಾಡಿ ನಮಗೆ ಪತ್ರವನ್ನು ಬರೀರಿ. ಶ್ರೀ ಬಸವ ಟಿವಿ, ಇದು ಸಂಸ್ಕಾರದ ಬೆಳಕು. ಎಲ್ಲರಿಗೂ ಶರಣು, ಶರಣಾರ್ಥಿ.
ಬಸವಲಿಂಗಾ.